Hello everyone, my name is Varun. Today we are going to look on BigIP F5 installation. So this is the minimum system requirement to install BigIP Virtual Edition. So for installing BigIP on VMware, you require a reservation of minimum 2 or 4 vCPUs and you require a minimum of 4 GB RAM. So RAM is equal to 2 into cores. So if you have one CPU core, then you require 2 GB RAM. If you have two CPU core, then you require 4 GB RAM. So for lab purpose, we will be using one CPU and 2 GB RAM. And in order to get the trial license of F5, you can visit f5.com/trials here. Once you visit this site, you can go for BigIP or BigIQ Virtual Edition. From here, you can log in to get the trial key. So as I have already downloaded the trial keys, so it's not giving me an option to download it more. Though this is the once you fill those information, you will be getting the trial keys like this. Then you can visit downloads.f5.com in order to download the Virtual Edition appliance. So I already have this downloaded. Here is my BigIP Virtual Edition appliance, and I will be installing it in my VMware workstation. So in order to install the file, in order to install that appliance, I'll go here. Will ask for a license agreement. You accept this license agreement. It will ask for a virtual machine name. I already have one appliance installed, so I'll just give it as standby. Here it will be getting installed. So I will, as this is a lab environment, so I'll be using one CPU and 2 GB RAM. Now it would be importing the appliance file. I'll just pause this video meanwhile this file is imported. Now the import is completed for my appliance. So it is deployed with a 2 GB of RAM, 1 vCPU, 76 GB of hard drive. And if we go to the settings, we can change the network adapter. So in our case, we will be using custom adapter. So the first adapter is always assigned to a management interface. So management interface, we will be using VMnet 0. For this one will be assigned to the internal interface. So we will be using VMnet 1 for this. And this will be assigned to the external interface. So we will be using VMnet 2 for this. I'll just apply these settings. Okay, now we are going to power on this virtual machine. Now the virtual appliance is powered on. So the default username and password is root. This is the username and the password is default. We have to change the password now, so we can check, we can put any password that we like. Let me try again. So the default username is root, default password is default. Now I have to change the password. Now I have changed the password. So as of now, it's showing no license because we haven't licensed the BIG-IP F5. So before proceeding further or before we can license it, we have to get the GUI access of this BIG-IP. For that, we have to first assign it a management IP. So as we already checked, we have assigned a VMnet 0 for the management adapter. So as we are doing this on VMware Workstation, so we are using VMnet 0 as a management adapter. So we have, if we check the VMnet 0 network, so VMnet 0 is in this network 192.168.27.0. So we will be assigning an IP in this network. So I will be using 192.168.27.3 as a management IP of it, as we are using VMnet 0 and VMnet 0 network for this workstation is 192.168.27. So in order to assign the IP, go to config. Can write configure. So we go to config in order to configure the management IP. From here we can configure the management IP. So we are going to configure IPv4. Now we will be assigning a different IP. So the IP would be in range of 192.168.27. So we will be giving 192.168.27.3. Subnet mask would be 24. If it is asking, would you like to configure default gateway? Yeah, we will be configuring it. So the default gateway would be this, the IP of our workstation, VMnet 0 adapter. So it will be 27.1. So this is the IP configuration. Hit yes. Once we hit yes, the IP is configured. So let's try to ping the IP. It seems like it haven't been configured as of now. So now the IP has been configured. So in order to check the current IP, we can use this command tmsh list sysmanagement IP, and it is showing that the IP of the management IP of the load balancer is 192.168.27.3. So we are going to access this IP now. So we are going to access the IP which we have assigned to the management interface. So it will connect us to F5. In order to log into the GUI, you have to use admin instead of root. So root works when you are working on CLI, and when you work on the GUI, you use admin. So you will first use the same password that you have configured for root. Then it will again prompt you to change the password. Just save this configuration. Now I am going to log in using new password. So this is the configuration utility. It is showing that your device is not licensed, so we have to first license the device. So we go to setup utility, click next. So we have to activate the license first, so click on activate. So it will ask for a base registration key. So once we register on the f5trial.com, we'll get the base registration key. So this is my base registration key for BigIP. So as I have done it for three appliances, so I got three keys. So I will be using this second one. I'll put it here. Now you have to generate a license from this registration key. So either you can go for automatic, but it requires an outbound connectivity to the F5 server, or else you can do it manual. So I'll go for manual. Click on next. Once you click next, you will be getting a dossier from using which you can create a key. So in order to create a key using in order to create a license using this dossier, you have to go to the licensing server by clicking here and copy this dossier. You have to enter the dossier here. Once you enter here, click on next. So this is our license. So just copy this license and accept the agreement condition. So you can copy the license from here once you accept the condition, and just paste that license here. So click on next now. Now our WIG IP is licensed. It is under evaluation license. So we can go to resource provisioning now. So now we can enable the different functionality of F5. So as of now, you can see the CPU reservation. This percent of CPU is used by the management process, whereas 89% of the CPU is used by the traffic management microkernel process of F5. So now we will be enabling LTM. So for LTM, we will be using a minimum resource. So now for LTM, this resource has been allocated this much of memory and this much of CPU. Apart from LTM, we will be using access policy manager, and this is again minimum. We will be not enabling the GTM here or ASM, so we will be only using LTM and APM. So now next. So it says that reprovisioning may restart the daemon or reboot the system, which causes lost connection. So we'll hit OK here. Once the provisioning is done, now we are on device certificate. So this is the default certificate of our F5. If you want to renew, if you want to import any new certificate, then you can do it here, but we will left it as it is. Now again it is asking for a management IP, so we are using this management IP 192.168.27.3 subnet master /24. This default gateway is 192.168.27.1. Host name, we can write any host name. I'll give it big IP dot local. It requires FKDN as well, so that is why we have given it dot local. Now host IP address, so we will be using management IP address as a host IP address. Time zone, we can change it if you want. We will leave it as it is. Now the root password, now we have to change the root account password, or we can set the previous one as well from here. So I'm going to set a new password for my root account. SSH, if you want to enable SSH, then you can enable from here. It asks whether you want to enable it for all addresses, or if you want to specify addresses through which you want to SSH. I'll do it from all addresses, then go next. Now we are under network configuration, so we do next. So config sync, display configuration, synchronization option, we check the config sync as yes. High availability, we are also enabling the high availability. And the failover method can be network serial cable or network serial cable. We will leave it as network. Next, we have to configure two VLANs. We have to configure the VLANs here. So we have to configure the self IP for those VLANs. So first of all, we will be configuring an internal VLAN, and we will be using the interface 1.1 for it. So the self IP of our internal VLAN would be 192.168.37.4. Networks will be 255.255.255.0. Port lockdown, or we will leave it as default. Floating IP. So floating IP is the one which is floating in between two F5s. So what we are doing here, we already have one F5 configured, and we are configuring a second F5. So the one which we have already configured has the self IP for internal VLAN as 192.168.37.2. And the floating IP is configured there already, that is 192.168.37.3. So we will be using same floating IP here. So this is required when you do a failover, then this particular floating IP is used. So I'll configure it as 37.3, which I have done on my other F5. So you can consider it as a virtual server, as a virtual IP that you create in HSRP. So while you are in HSRP, you give two different IPs to two switch or two routers, and there is one floating IP, that is virtual IP, which floats on the primary router, which remains on the primary router, right? So similarly, this floating IP address will remain on the primary router. So you will be configuring the virtual server, the default gateway of your backend server in case of single arm load balancer as the floating IP. So if one load balancer fails, the traffic will go to the other load balancer. So this is kind of virtual IP. Now we select internal here. For interfaces, we will do VLAN. We will be untagging the VLAN interface, and so we are using 1.1 for our internal VLAN. Now next. And just to show you again, if we go out to our workstation, and if I go to the settings, see this particular first adapter is used for management, second is 1.1. So we have assigned an IP in VMnet 1 network. So if I just show you the IP of VMnet 1 network, VMnet 1, okay. So here we have to change it because we have assigned the IP to the internal 1.1 interface on this range. So what we will do, we will make it VMnet 2 and we will make this one as VMnet 1. So as I told you already, that this interface is for management, right? So that is why we assigned a IP to a management interface on this network, whereas this is for 1.1 adapter. So we have already assigned the IP in this subnet, so we have given it VMnet 2. Now the 1.2 would be this one, so for which we are using VMnet 1. So the IP is in range of 192.168.110. So for external VLAN, we will be giving an IP in range of 192.168.110. So let me go back to the configuration. So for external VLAN, the IP would be 192.168.110.4. Netmask will be 255.255.255.0. Default gateway would be 192.168.110.1, which is this one. Now floating IP, similarly in case of internal VLAN, we are again going to assign a floating IP to the external VLAN, which will be used in case of HF failover. So same we have assigned to our other big IP which we have already configured, that is 110.3. Now we will be using 1.2 for it, that will be again untagged. We added. Now next. Okay, I have assigned an incorrect IP, it should be 192. Now next. For high availability, in case of high availability, it is asking, do we need to create a VLAN for high availability or we will be using the existing VLAN? So we will be using the existing VLAN in our case, and that would be external VLAN that we will be using. Or if you want, you can create a new VLAN for HA. You can simply go over here, create a new VLAN. You can use a third adapter in our case, and you can assign an IP. But in our case, we will be using the existing VLAN, the external VLAN. NTP, if you want to configure NTP, as of now, I'm going to skip this. DNS again, we are not going to configure the DNS. So this is asking the address which will be used to sync configuration between two load balancers that are in HA. So for config sync, we will be using our internal adapter, that is 1.1, to sync the config with our HA node. Now it is asking a management failover unicast configuration. So in case of management failover, which interface would you like to use for it? I'll select management address, then next. And now mirroring configuration. So mirroring configuration is needed if, let's say, if you have two F5s, right, and you have configured them in HA. This, you are syncing the configuration in between two, these two F5. But what happen if in case, if one of the F5 fails, right, and you have the existing connection on that F5, then those will be automatically transferred to the other HA node using the mirroring configuration. So this interface will be used for mirroring the configuration from in between the F5s. Now we are going to finish this configuration. So setup utility is completed now. Now I'll just reload this F5. So now our F5 is good to go. We have configured LTM, local traffic manager, so we are getting an option for LTM here. Now as we configured the network interfaces, we can see the interfaces here. These are our interface list. We have configured two interfaces. One is for internal VLAN, another one for the external VLAN. Under device management, we can have an overview of device groups. So as of now, we haven't configured any device groups, so we can configure the device group if you want a two device to be in HA. So that we will be doing in our next class. So I believe this video is informational for you. I will post how we can configure two devices in HA in my next class. So please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.